Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Both, of course. You know, I keep wondering about this. Meeting this guy. Ward? It says in the evening, but it's like 2:37 a.m. Oh, it's close by. Wait, not really. What? Why does it say 750 meters? That's further away than... Well, let's go see if he's there. I hate when my hair disappears like that. And if he's not there, I'll just handle some stuff around nearby. Side jobs and assaults in progress, stuff like that. I guess it is close. I guess it is how far away it is. I guess it's not that far. Okay. It looked further away on the map. It looked like miles away or kilometers away, whatever. Okay, so let's see if he'll meet with us. That we'll go keep ourselves busy until the evening, the actual evening of whatever day this is now. Now returning here. Oops. Sit and wait for River. Meaning, am I waiting until the evening? Like, all day? I'm supposed to wait over here. Looks like this is the place. Sit and wait. Okay. Time is... Wait. Alright. It's just before 3 a.m. See what time it is when I'm...
Well, this is the place. Tick, 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 tick.
Let's see what time it is when we're done waiting. You gotta be kidding me. I was right. We didn't have to... I would have tackled a lot of stuff until... Never mind. I thought we missed it because I didn't take a note at the time at which we got the quest. So we literally sat around here for 15 hours. Man, this better be worth it. Oh. He didn't even pull up near me. He went up all the way up over here. Hi.
Hey, V.
I waited a long time.
How you holding up?
Been better.
Yeah, I imagine so.
I know. Probably not hard to tell.
So I forget. Is this the one, the optional thing? Nice ride?
Nice ride. Brand new?
Nope.
Not in a chatty mood, I see.
Not really. Sorry.
Okay, that's the optional. Okay, so what's the issue?
So, what happened?
Needed someone to talk to.
Mm-hmm.
First, take a look.
What are you looking at? WNS News?
Hello, my name is Arif Iqbal, and this is WNS News.
More municipal politics?
More dead politicians?
Just watch it.
...led the NCPD to the trail of a dangerous abductor and murderer. The incident occurred at the intersection of 7th and 15th Avenue. The following police footage was captured at the scene. 1038, I repeat.
Is this your cam?
Registration 2AA6244. We're exiting our vehicle now.
Copy that.
Out of the car! Hands up! Easy, officer. Relax.
Anthony?
Shut your mouth! Oh, shit. We have a 1053 and a 1054. I repeat, a 1053 and a 1054.
What's that stand for? Oops, it's down.
The boy from the footage is LeVar Martinez, age 17. His parents reported his disappearance over a month ago. Unfortunately, LeVar's life could not be saved. His body could not withstand the severe septic shock he suffered.
What?
Autopsy reports reveal the teenager was given dangerously high levels of hormones, anabolic steroids, and stimulants.
Oh my god.
The possessions and genetic material of 7 other missing teens were also found in the car, belonging to one Anthony Harris.
Oh jeez.
Unfortunately, their fates remain unknown. Although the criminal widely known as Peter Pan survived the gunshot, he has not regained consciousness, making interrogation impossible. Please stay tuned to WNS News for developments in the story.
Is Peter Pan is a case of yours?
This Peter Pan, he an old case? You were looking for him?
Never heard of him. Didn't cross my desk.
So it looks like they caught him.
What's the problem if they caught the guy?
My nephew, Randy. Disappeared not long past. And what you just saw. The kid was wearing Randy's shoes.
Oh, Jesus.
Crap. Tell me more about the disappearance.
Randy's disappearance. Know anything else?
My sister and I don't get along that well. I don't know much. Just wish I could have been there for her when she needed it most.
You haven't been assigned to the search?
What, they figured you'd get emotional and kept you off the case?
More like a restraining order. Won't let me anywhere near it. Gonagall took the lead on it. Lazy ass gonk. And so far, he ain't accomplished shit.
I wouldn't let it go if I were you.
No way I'd let this lie.
I know. And that's why I'm asking for your help.
So what do we need to do?
Can't interrogate the guy because he's a veg, but we can view his dreams.
Sorry. Dreams?
Really?
You heard me. Come on, I'll explain on the way.
I'm gonna jack into his brain box there.
It's an experimental procedure, but it's already yielding results. They record dreams that can be played back as BDs.
Oh, wow. You got access to these dreams?
Got access to these dreams?
Not yet, but they keep them in the lab we're headed to now.
You almost got hit there. You don't
okay.
care.
Got an appointment?
Not exactly. We'll go in together, but not through the main entrance.
Oh, we're gonna break the law.
Breaking the law.
We'll find a different way in, and then hustle out quick. Never actually been here, so I'll need your help.
Find a way inside the lab. Am I supposed to go this way? No. Because he said not through the front entrance, but that looks like an exit. Private property, keep out, no warning shots. Am I letting him in from there? He was coming with me.
Okay, shouldn't be anyone inside.
Oh.
The lab's in the middle of an audit, so make all the noise you want.
How are we gonna find this brain dance?
Look for a room where they edit the dreams of autistic kids. Oh, and remember, Peter Pan's real name is Anthony Harris.
Right. Teachings at the temple. Excerpts. Excerpts. Should I read that? Is that relevant? The welcome truth that sleep and death are twin sisters, beneficent, healing, and vivifying is gradually making its way through the scientific as well as the religious world, bearing on its winos faith and trust in the fundamental lays of life which underlie all phenomena, and casting down forever the great Moloch of fear. What's a Moloch? Moloch of fear, which stands at the gate of all men's minds, ready to devour each child of hope which has been conceived and born in the joy of life. Time and space are annihilated in dream life because of the rapid action of the energy of mind when freed from the bonds of matter, and life in the state of dream is a foretaste of what life may be when the coarser grades of matter, which now hold the embryonic God-man in bondage, are refined, and the energy which now must act under all the difficulties man has ignorantly thrown up by unnatural, unwise methods and practices through countless incarnations will then be guided and controlled by the higher or spiritual will of man for the perfecting of a body as much superior to the bodies of the present races of mankind as the latter are superior to those of animal creation. Okay, whatever. Oh, I got stuck on something. Use Kuroshi. Right, let's
scan. They definitely don't store any BDs in this area.
Oh, he said nobody should be here. I'd be surprised if that's not true. Got a crunch.
Locked. Can't get in.
Messages. No, no, no. Caroline Adams to Taryn Doggett. LOL. And just remember not to mention our lastest study to those NCPD slug brains because they, well, they just wouldn't understand it anyway. Security update from Nomi Redweed to research team. Important. I would like to remind everyone of the upcoming audit and changes in security. I'm willing to answer any immediate questions you might have. As you're aware, we've had complaints from the NCPD. I know, but we will have to follow the new guidelines. There's no wiggle room on this. At a time to be determined later, you will all get your new double verification access signatures. You will each receive individual emails with the relevant details. No more of that reply all funny business. Until then, continue your work as normal, of course, excluding the day we have assigned for the audit. Have a nice day, security. A small step for science, a giant leap for mankind. From Eugene Kuzma to research team. Good morning, all. I would like to congratulate our very own Dr. Yawin Packard on the recent strides he has made in the field of pediatric autism therapy. Her invaluable work has paved the way for more effective therapy applications than the established behavioral methods. Teach ESDM and RDI, clearly surpassing all supportive methods, e.g. sensory integration, and substantially building upon traditional traditional approaches such as music therapy. I speak for all of us when I say we're extremely proud of Dr. Packard's scientific achievements, but also, more importantly, proud to see the huge inflow of warm letters from happy parents. Keep up the great work, everyone. Eugene Kuzma. Important. All staff, please read. From Cy Swearingen to research team. Dear team, I like to beat around the bush as much as the next guy, but I'm afraid I don't have that luxury this time. First of all, you will remember that framed quote I used to have in my office, never trust a person who's never tried to steal. Well, it seems someone took that sentiment too much to heart. Now, don't panic. It wasn't the quote that was stolen. It's safely at home. Rather, it appears a staff member has taken our neurotransmitter research files from the facility with the likely intent of selling them to a third party. As such, all lab employees will be required to take a polygraph before leaving the facility, led by our own Dr. Al Tolliver. If Al finds anything troubling from your test, the next course of action would be termination, legal action, or both. No jokes. I mean this in all seriousness. Well, a polygraph's not admissible in court. Let me emphasize, do the polygraph before leaving work, then you're free to get in your naps, showers, lap dances, or whatever it is you people do in your off hours. Have a pleasant day, sigh. Project decisions for next quarter, from Yolanda Castaneda to research team. Important, the following projects have been green-lighted to continue next quarter. Neurotransmitters and selective countermeasures in combating the effects of stress, cyberpsychosis, audiovisual stimulation in autism therapy, limited environmental stimulation as treatment for antisocial behavior. We've decided to suspend research into transcendental meditation. All those involved in the project will soon receive a more detailed report about the indefinite suspension and information regarding new project allocations. Really? Right. So I'm supposed to scan this. Am I? Maybe not. Or the desk. Audit records. Dossier Anthony Harris, probability of being found close to 0%. So wait, what about... Oh, was I looking at that thing? Shard, research on neurotransmitters. I can't pick that up. Nothing in here. Oh. Here's the same ones. Alright, so we've read this, right? And we've read that. Meditation work. Heard the news. From Aliyuti Kochama to Carolyn Adams. I just saw the email. I'm sorry to hear they cut your project. If it's any consolation, I've tried to apply your methods in my personal time, and I feel like my creativity is on a whole other level. Seriously. I really hope this is just temporary and they reinstate the project, though I've got bad feelings since Dr. Lynch's departure. There just hasn't been the same support. Hang in there, Caroline. Oh, Carolyn, don't lose hope. All staff. Yeah, these are like bulletins for everybody. From Anna Svart Fasting, City Auditor, to NCPD Labs, this week's audit. As many of you know, this week's audit is simply a formality. We are required by law to periodically evaluate current laboratory safeguards for effectiveness and future modernization efforts. Remember that this audit is as beneficial for the city's bookkeeping as it is to keep you and your research safe. We're all playing for the same team here. Please just treat this as a mandatory day off. Best regards, Anna Svart Fasting, City Auditor. A novel phobia. Fear of the number? Number 91? Huh. In recent years, the list of commonly feared numbers such as 4, 13, and 66 have grown to now officially include the number 91. While the phobias of other numbers have origins well studied by science, e.g. tetraphobia derives from the fact that the Chinese words for death and four sound similar, really, we can still only hypothesize about the rise of 91. Patients affected by a phobia of the number 91 often complain of recurring nightmares in which a giant countdown reaches 91 then suddenly stops. When they attempt to restart the countdown, it transforms into a bright yellow board with vermin crawling all over it. Really? This shared experience has already spawned unproven conspiracy theories, which, among other things, claim that the dreams are transmitted via either electromagnetic waves, the digitized minds of a mysterious Netrunner sect, rogue artificial intelligences, or classified nanochips installed by Night Corp agents. None of these outlandish ideas contain a grain of truth, of course, so what is it that causes the phobia to manifest such intense reactions? That much remains unknown, but as so many scientists often claim, the truth is out there. Well, they're all having the same, or many of them often have the same dream, with a countdown and then a bright yellow board with vermin crawling out. Like, that's pretty specific. So without full knowledge of the phobia's origin and its underlying factors, how can you treat it? Studies thus far have shown promising results for conditioning patients via induced dream states in which the number 91 is inverted to the number 19. Although this method remains in clinical trials, experts optimistic the 91% success rate will only continue to improve, really. That has a 91% success rate. Okie dokie. So, should I go that way or this way? What's that? Oh god. There's a little embryo in there? Definitely enjoying looking around. Got some notes here. A list of tasks to check. Three methoxym and EEG. A random candle just placed here. HR documents. Better keep looking. Okay. Plastic and metal. This device stimulates conditions in the uterus, maintains the life of the BB, and detects BTs. Damn stool. Security update. Ewan Packard, or Yowen, whatever. Please read. Got that. Okay, I read all that. And we read this. Okay, so got, what is it? Report filed to NCPD. Unfortunately, it doesn't appear at the top, so I have to wait for it to scroll over. Subject AH. Oh, is it Anthony? What's his name? Patient transported to hospital 18 minutes after suffering missile wound to the head. As the missile penetrated multiple brain layers, a temporary pulse cavity immediately followed. Due to rapid intervention, intracranial pressure was reduced and inflammatory damage to brain tissue was avoided. Despite successful intervention, the patient remains in a coma with estimated chances of waking at only 0.6%. In the event the patient does wake, likely complications may include paresis in the right side of the body, vision impairment, speech impairment, and cognitive disorders. Estimated value for NCPD investigation, near zero. Interesting. All activities are recorded. Oh, Dr. Havoc and Rita. This is the same place I was just in. Who's that? Oh, is that? That's Ward. Never mind. Well, I can't open that one. Disappointing. Ah. It's the bathrooms. I don't want to look in the mirror. I want to get that. And that. How did he get in there? Must have found another door. Got a cute little sink. Isn't that adorable? Outer space, my life in orbit. I'll read that another time. Doesn't seem relevant to our searchings here. Let me out. Packard. From Taryn Doggett to Naomi Redweed and Jean-Paul Petit. Based on the latest research on the subject, it appears the patient suffers from relapses of antisocial behaviors. The recommended treatment approach is limited environmental stimulation and increased doses of neuroleptics. See treatment details and attachment. I'll remind you, this is not an isolated case, but a fairly common problem among members of MaxTac. The NCPD is pushing for more resources put into cyberpsychosis research, but our facility simply can't accommodate an uptick right now. And a friendly reminder, please email your applications for overtime next quarter by no later than tomorrow, end of day. This week's audit? Yes, okay. And then that's that thing. 91. Okay, brain dance conditioning in. Oh, it says it here. In cyberpsychosis. Studies that use brain imaging methodologies have shown a progressive reduction in brain volume, but a swelling of the ventricular system and the volume of cerebrospinal fluid produced in people who suffer from cyberpsychosis. Other studies have found differences in the degree of cortical nerve cell depletion between stage 1 cyberpsychosis patients treated pharmaceutically and those who received brain dance conditioning. Increased loss of cortical nerve cells was detected in those using pharmaceutical treatment, from which it has been concluded that brain dance conditioning has a neuroprotective effect. This experiment's results should be taken into account when implementing brain dance conditioning methods in locations with minimal environmental stimulation present. Okay. Kind of interesting, but doesn't have to do with what we're trying to find here. Same here. audit around the corner, from Seth Givens NCPD to Cy Swearingen. What's up, Chumster? You know about that audit in your lab is coming up, right? Maybe get those invoices for Wu all squared away, huh? Oh. Seems a little corrupt there. From Cy to Seth Givens. Don't you got enough of your own paperwork to push around? Leave the invoices for Wu to me. Make sure our little piggies don't go hungry. Braindance treatment. Pediatric autism. Introduction. Activity in the developing brain is higher compared to that in a mature brain. This greater capacity to establish neural connections and reorganize cortical and subcortical brain structures allows for substantial compensating abilities even in circumstances of extensive brain damage. Unfortunately, in the case of children on the autism spectrum, the problem is one of hyperactivity. Overabundance of firing synapses results in synaptic communication disorders. This study compared children on the autistic spectrum who did not receive any preventative measures with those who received early brain dance therapy. Initial findings suggest the brain dance treatment provides beneficial support for synaptic function. Please refer to subsequent reports for detailed summaries of the findings. Okay. Perhaps I will. And a ram jolt in there. Receipts and invoices. Trail of spilled whiskey. He's reminding me again. I'm gonna go there last. It's probably in there where he is. That. Geez, from Jean Paul Petit to Yolanda Castaneda. You read Kuzmo's email congratulating Yawin? Eugene must have been very pleased with her strides. From Yolanda. I'm not surprised. I mean, she cozies up with that cop, then all of a sudden gets an NCPD contract. What a coinky dink, huh? From Jean Paul. Exactly. Slanty, frowny face. And we've read that, and we've read that. Fear of the number 91, yes, we've read that. Okay. Oh, wait. Nice, 454-80s there. NCPD, Anatomy of a Disaster, I think I have that one. Like, who the hell's saying that? I think I went in everything except the middle one. Yeah, which is that one. Okay. Let's go join him in here. We're in there. Find anything?